So today we are going to learn how to play the trumpet, or in my case, the cornet. So first off, for holding it, you're going to put, your left hand is going to be doing all the work for holding the instrument. So you want your ring finger through this little ring right here, and then your pinky over it, and then you just want to kind of hold it however's comfortable. I hold it like this with my left hand. So my left hand is doing all of the work to hold the instrument so that my right hand can be completely relaxed. So my right hand, my thumb is going to go right in here between the first and second valves and kind of rest it up against this bar right here. And then my three fingers right on top of the valves. And then my pinky is going to be on top of this ring right here. If your students are anything like me, they're going to want to put their pinky in the ring. Don't let them do that, because that can eventually create some tension, and we just want to, like, completely get rid of that possibility. So, again, completely holding it with your left hand, and then your thumb right in here between the valves, and your first three fingers right here, and your pinky resting on top of the ring. So that's how you hold it, and then for playing, you want to make sure that your back is completely straight, and that your chin is level to the ground, like this. And then you want to bring your trumpet up to you. You don't want to morph your face down to your trumpet. You don't want to bring your face to the instrument. You want the instrument to be brought up to your face. So like this. Okay. So then another thing for your left hand is that for some notes, we're going to have to kick out this, what's called the third valve slide, like this. It goes in and out. So you want to make sure that you have a nice amount of your finger like through the slide so that you can easily move it. What I do is I picture flexing my hand out like this. So when my hand is in there, I think of flexing my hand out like this, and it moves it a pretty good amount. So anyway, so you want to make sure that you bring it up to your face. Your right hand is completely comfortable, and your left hand is doing all the work. Then, for air and embouchure, I recommend starting out with a straw. That way, when you're blowing through the straw, you're focusing all of your air through that tiny little hole, which is to represent this, the tiny hole at the end of the mouthpiece, is the smallest that is the smallest area that your air is going to have to go through. So it's important to make sure that your air is all focused into one small kind of tunnel. And it also helps with your embouchure. So when you're blowing through the straw, it kind of puckers your lips up and it brings your corners down on the end of your smile. We play brass, so we frown because we're sad. And then in order to kind of create the sound when you're blowing, your lips will kind of buzz, like, so that when you have your mouthpiece or your instrument and you're doing all of that, it makes a sound. And then when you put the mouthpiece into the instrument, you want to make sure that you're blowing really strong and get. So for articulations, you can teach do or to. I personally do do, and then for stronger like accented notes, I'll say to. But either way, when you're teaching that, you want to make sure that as they're saying, like, two, 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 that air is going through. So what you can do is you can put your hand up to your face and say, two, 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 two. And you want to make sure that there's air hitting your hand at all times. That kind of teaches them to just keep blowing the air through the notes instead of kind of you want to make sure that the air is constant until they have to take it back. So you will have. Instead of a. Okay. And then another thing is to make sure that ear training is really important for brass instruments. If you don't hear the note before you play it, you can frack it. So when you're teaching young players, you want to sing all the time. You want to sing the note, and then you want them to sing with you, and then you want them to play. So you'll sing la, and then you have everybody sing it with you, and then... So, a danger for brass instruments is if you don't hear the note in advance, I could be trying to play, but if I'm hearing, then it kind of comes out as, and it's really awkward and nobody wants that. So, again, in order to avoid that, just keep singing, have your students sing with you to really help with their ear training, and that helps things go a lot smoother. So, yeah.